who do you have here?
This is Zainab, Zainab's my father, Joseph.
So who is this lady here? Hello, please meet you.
This is my girlfriend.
Your what?
My girlfriend, Zainab.
What's the matter with her?
Well, she looks quite normal. She's expecting.
Come on, sit down. Let's talk about this. Have you told her about that? Can you go around a bit? So, who is it? She's pregnant.
Yes, she's pregnant, as you can see.
Is it your kid, boy?
Well, she wouldn't be doing my kid if she was sitting there, would it?
No, never can tell. You know these young girls these days, you know?
Well,
nothing bad against you, love, but...
I know it's my kid.
So how long have you known this young lady?
10 months.
Oh, 10 months? Yeah. And you about to?
I've never actually mentioned her to...
I must have heard
him talk on the phone about this, Zainab.
Nothing really. I never knew
it
got this far. Your parents were
pregnant.
So what did your parents say about that?
My parents didn't like him, they chucked her out.
What?
They chucked her out.
So that means that she...
And they'll was asking if she can stay here.
Because there's no else she can go, she's chucked.
that is a different story now, Sylverius. I don't think I can have that.
Well, it's gonna be...
Are you working with her? You're not working? You're not working? She's not working? Did you say that
Well, what can we do? I mean, I'm gonna try if I can find her parents. If I can talk to her mother, maybe we can sort something out.
So that means you're taking the responsibility on your hands?
But it's my son. I've got to do something to help. I just can't sit back and watch things happen.
Look.
Someone's got to help these poor kids.
Yeah, but what was the matter with her parents? She should be home with her parents.
I've told you.
A young girl pregnant like this, she should be at home with her parents. If he was a boy and he was in college.
He's off, man. She's upset now.
You've upset her. Look, if her parents...
Yeah, but it doesn't make any sense me pretending with her. Right? I'm pretending with this.
I'm not pretending.
I am not pretending at all. I said I don't want you all to be here.
Oh,
it's nothing against you personally, love. You must get that straight.
How would you like if I told her that my girlfriend had an abortion, being Catholic as you are.
Now that would change the whole story.
How would it change it? I'd have felt worse about it. I'm sure you
would. Maybe it would have been. It would be the best thing to do.
No,
really.
You would have said that. You would have said that. Wouldn't you? But I would have done it.
She cannot have an abortion now.
She won't have abortion. I won't have abortion. It's my kid, so therefore I tend to look.
When did you tell your mother that you was pregnant? When it showed. You was too frightened. I mean, her parents obviously haven't got no understanding whatsoever.
Have you talked to the parents?
I haven't met her parents. I've just met this young girl.
But I think you should get in contact with the parents and see what the parents say, really, because we can't really have this. No? She's had one kid now, next thing she'll be pregnant again.
The girl's petrified. Look at her. She's crying. She's afraid.
What is she afraid of? I'm afraid as well. I'm afraid that they'll be here forever and ever. We can't have that.
Why?
You know, we can't have that.
For a short while. They can stay here for a short while. Have you been to the clinic, love?
I think we must have a serious chat about this, really, because I really don't agree with this.
Well, this is serious. I'm possibly serious because I feel that.
No, but I want a personal. I want a husband and wife chat with her, but you are not here. I really like to get a chance to talk.
You're not
to
telling
about
them
no,
to go.
No, you're not going yet. No. When it comes to something,
we've all got to talk together. I mean, we haven't got her parents here. We've got the two of them, and it is their problem.
The fact is that she's expecting is my child, so therefore she hasn't got home to go.
Are you sure about
I've
that?
I've got home to go.
Are you sure that it's your kid, Sylverius?
It is my kid. I'm not a fat kid.
I'm not the type of person that would go with any Tom, Dick and Harry.
No, dear, we're not saying that.
But he is. That's what he's coming
I'm
to.
I'm not really saying that in so many words, but.
But he said it several times now, and that's what he's saying all the time.
I want the best for you, Sylverius. I want to make sure that you are all.
You want the best for me.
I want to make sure that you don't have a ready-made jacket on your back, boy.
Does. I've never burdened anyone with anything that wasn't theirs. Don't worry about that. No.
Okay, Emily, go upstairs and we'll check. I'll leave
you soon. Because prayer would help.
She's crying because she's afraid. She's young and she's afraid. When I was younger, I'd be afraid too.
I understand, but would you put it that? Would your parents have put it with that? Your brother
We're in a
home
different time
here.
Now.
Anyway. Let me get myself a drink. Yeah, you were saying.
He's done the right thing. He's come to us. She obviously talked to her parents. She tried. She got no response. She got her mother here, actually.
Did she?
Yeah.
She's one of those women, no?
Her mother's obviously very upset about what we are, but at least one part of the family's got to have some understanding.
But I would prefer not to be this part of the family, really.
Listen. He, at least he bought a home. He's trying to make things work. He's trying to do something. He's not leaving it all up to us.
So what did he decide to do then?
They want to stay here for a while until he gets a job. Then they try and get a place of their own.
I leave that decision up to you, but I will let you know
right now
that I am not pleased with you.
Fair enough, you're not pleased. I'm not over the moon about this, but I've got to help.
Alright then, you decide what you decide. I said I'm not pleased with it, and that is my final word, right? You organize what you want to organize between you and them, and we'll go from there, right?
Drink's not going to help you. Oh, God. Where could they be now?
I don't know, love. You tell me. You should know your son, you know? You're always backing him up and defending him all the time.
You know, they won't be upset. I mean, it's been 3 days since they've been gone.
And it's nearly 4 days now. Where could he be, though?
I don't know what's happened. I really don't.
Anybody's wrong where he's gone is no good friends, you know? So where could she be?
Do you think they've gone back to her parents' house to have a chat? Maybe they've gone back?
Anyway, I'm here happy enough. I'm having my drink, you know. I don't really mind about nobody else, really.
But I'm worried sick. I haven't slept 2 nights. It's getting to be dragged now.
Yeah, that's up to you, love. I get my sleep as long as I can get a few beers in my head. I'll sleep anywhere, you know.
I wonder if I should phone this friend.
Have you got the numbers? Do you know?
I'll have a look at the search. Maybe it's best not to.
No, I wouldn't work it anyway. Boy, as I said, the boy is no good. He don't even worth worrying about.
He is worth worrying about.
No, you would worry about him, but I wouldn't worry about him.
I can't just turn a blind eye to everything that happens in this house, you know.
I know that, but you worry too much. You make it seem as though he's the most important thing in your life.
He is the most, one of the most important things in my life.
See, there he goes again, you see. So where do I come now?
He is important. He's my son, and he's your son too. You don't seem to want to have no part with this thing. I mean, it'll be your grandchild as well as mine.
I'm not saying that. All I'm worried about is, I'm not really worried, but I'm worried because you're worried that he hasn't been home the past few days.
I'm
sure that turned out. I mean, couldn't bloody fun. But I would put it down to you, though. It's your fault.
Why is it my fault?
From the time the boy was a kid, he was a sweet little boy. You know what I mean? I try to bring him in the right way, and you spoil him, you give him whatever you wanted.
I had not spoiled him.
Whenever I talk to him, you always make sure that you go on his side.
You can't. It's because you can't talk to him. You're always shouting and hollering. You don't wait to listen to him.
That is the best way. You give him a clip on the ear once or twice.
It's not always the best way.
I'm saying, if you'd love me to continue chastising the guy, how I know I should have chastised him, this wouldn't have never happened.
Look, that could happen any time. I mean, lots of children are pregnant nowadays. You don't... You're home. Where have you been?
Where have you been, boy?
Something very drastic's happened.
What? Couldn't you phone or nothing?
Well, it would make more sense if I did phone.
What do you mean it would make no sense? I was sitting here worried about you.
I know, but check it really.
You could have still phoned. I've been sitting there 3 days waiting for a phone call or something. You just left and didn't
well, I didn't think that it would be much.
No, don't think you can.
Can't you care about?
Of course I care about you.
Then why couldn't you phone?
Because like I said, right, if I did phone, I mean, what's the difference?
So that's why.
Well, what's happened is that I went to a party.
A party? With a pregnant woman?
Let me finish.
Whose party did you go to?
Trevor, my friend.
Trevor who?
Trevor.
Who the hell's Trevor?
What sort of party is it?
School friend. It's a party.
What sort of party?
What party did you go to?
Well, let me finish what I'm saying first, then you
listen to the party. You took her to a party and she's pregnant.
I think, let me finish, then you know what I'm going to say, then you find out for yourself. No. Trevor phoned me up, friend Zainab, she's got to a party.
Around Zainab's house? That means she must have seen her parents?
Well, no, we're not going to get some more clothes.
So where were her parents at the time?
Well, parents just happened not to be in, because that's the key, right? So Tristan's ready to party on Friday. Is that a
our sister said you can't come to the party because in your condition. So anyway, I turned around, I said, Zainab, behind me. I talked to her, I said to her to go home.
But so you could have taken her, you could have brought her here.
Bring her here. What good is going to do her? I mean, she'd have walked out, that's probably why she would come to the party, because she knew that she'd stay here. It's like, we'll drive her away anyway. Anyway, like I was saying, to get out, the fight broke out.
A fight broke out in the party?
Fight, yeah.
Were you fighting, boy?
I was not fighting, listen.
Were you involved in the fight?
Listen, wait, let me finish. The fight broke out, in the rush to get out, she got trampled on.
How could she get trampled on when you're there? How could you see a fight happening and still stand there with a pregnant woman? Why don't you just come home?
Is she badly hurt? Did she get hurt badly?
Well, she's in the hospital.
Were you involved in the fight?
No. I said, when I see the fight.
When you saw the fight, that means you must have sensed there was something going on. You could have taken her out.
Yeah.
But you chose to stay there.
Sensei, I was trying to take her out, but in the rush to get out, she got trampled on. And she was behind me, and she fell on the floor. She was in pain, so I said to Trevor to find an ambulance for her.
And who?
And she was in hospital.
Is this Trevor that had the party? Was it his party?
It's his party. Good for you, not Trevor. Good friend of mine.
I
don't
know Trevor. I didn't even know Zainab. You've been going there for 10 months.
Anyway, she's in hospital. She could lose the baby.
Nah, that's just done it. I mean, are you sensitive or something?
I'm not saying that. I think that could be a blessing in disguise for the boy, you know?
That's all you can say because you don't care. You don't give a damn about nothing.
Listen, take that off the table, you're not...
The table is not important right now, look.
There you go again, you're jumping on his...
I'm going to put us back. See where she is, yeah.
You're spending the boy all the time. If you would take as I do.
I can't take as you do because I'm not you.
I wanted you to bring the boy in the right way.
I tell you
from the beginning, never give him his own way. You know? Treat him with a firm hand.
You always blame me anyway for everything that happens in this bloody house. You just turn around and blame
me. Anything that happens with him, I do blame you because I know for sure that you are to blame.
Well, anyway, the girl's in hospital now. It's more serious than anything else. So can't you even consider the fact that, all right, things went wrong, but now she's not well.
Why is she not there? So what can we do about that? What are we
going
to do about that?
We have to sort something out.
Something like what? What can we sort out?
First fact, where is she going to go after the hospital? And she's not going to stay there forever, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's another thing, yes.
So then what are we going to do?
I don't know.
Well, you better think. Or she's staying here with me.
Mom, she's lost a baby.
She's lost a baby?
So what are we going to do then? What is she going to do?
What are you going to do? You can't do nothing. You don't do nothing.
But when she comes out of hospital, she'll have to come here.
Well, she can't go to Wales, can she? She has to come.
Of course she can go somewhere. So I,
where can she go?
I can be ready to turn and say not let her in here in the first place. No?
You do what you like for what, okay, anyway. Do what you like.
It can't be my fault. How can it be my fault? You blame everything on me.
It's your fault.
How can
you
it be my
hadn't
fault?
Been so strong about things also. I don't know, it's your fault as well. Wait on to you thoroughly.
So what are we going to do now? What's going to happen from there?
God knows what's going to happen from
here. Everybody will know that it's my fault. I chased the girl out of the place and I sent her to a party. Are you going to blame that on me as well?
I'm not saying you sent her to a party, but you could...
Listen, love, I had enough of this, right?
You've
had enough of this, right?
What do you mean you've had enough? You've had enough drink?
I don't want to hear no more about this.
You will hear a lot more about it. You will have to hear a lot more about it.
I just don't want to hear no more about this hospital talk.
Why? Right? You can't take with you what you've caused?
Who caused it? I never caused it.
It was your fault. If you hadn't said what you said, then they wouldn't have walked out.
Listen, lady, you're making me vexed now. I'm getting annoyed.
I don't care how vexed you are. I'm hurt.
I am getting annoyed. Do you want to be hurt?
I don't care.
You shut me in this place. There's only one man in this place. You hear what I tell you?
That's all you fit to do, isn't it? Fitness, all you could ever do, drink and violence.
You sit down in the place, young man. Huh?
You sit down. I think you can do anything but sit down and drink the tenants.
Listen.
Come on, that's what I'm not speaking to. I think you got no feelings whatsoever. You're not you, man. You understand? You're just a frame of drink. Take your drink, go on, take it.
Listen, where you are going?
Take it, that's your business. You don't care. Listen,
you are, if you're going to leave this place, you leave this place and don't come back.
Fair enough,
right? Don't come back in my place, right?
Fair enough, take your house, right? Take your tenants, take it.
And if I can't have my way, I'll burn the house down, you know that?
You go back to the hospital for more checkups though, won't you?
No. But they asked me to go back.
You should go back after, say, about a month. So go back for a checkup and have a look at you.
I thought the doctor would ask you to go back if you wanted you to go back.
No, love that. I mean, you've had a nasty accident. You should go back to make sure you're okay. And then while there, you can always talk about going on the pill. And then he'll send you to clinic and you can have an examination.
Right.
I'm a bit frightened to go. Oh, don't
worry.
Would you like some tea though?
No, thank you. Can I watch
Penny, please? No, I would
like to talk to you,
really. What do you want
to talk about? You. Oh.
Good evening. Oh, good evening.
This is Trevor.
Hello, Trevor.
Nice to meet you, Mrs. Trevor.
Nice. Where are you from, love?
I'm from St. Lucia. I see you've got a map of St. Lucia.
Yes, yes.
You alright, sir?
Sit down.
Thanks.
Well, Trevor.
Yes, this is Trevor.
Talk to you now.
Yes.
It was your party.
Well, yes, it was. And I mean, I'm always having parties. It was unfortunate that Zainab had an accident because in my parties, nothing ever happens that way.
It's nice for you to come along and have a chat though.
Well, yes, I mean, I said that I would, you know, when Sylverius was telling me all about it, I felt very, very bad, you know, because it happened with something that I organized, you know, and then the parties I've had before, nothing like that.
Well, you do have a lot of parties then?
Well, yes, I do, really, because it's one way of, well, you know, the unemployment situation, you see, I mean, it's one way of making some money, you know. I mean, we all got to live, you know what I mean? You know, and I don't charge him a lot of money. It's only £1 to come in. And, I mean, you sell a little drink there, although the police don't really like that. But, and I just felt that I had to come and say, you know.
That was really thoughtful of you.
Yes. I mean, I'm sorry what happened to Zainab, really, because Zainab is a nice guy. I've known Zainab for a long time, and Sylvester's your son. And I'm very nice to meet you at last, you know. I mean, you're very pretty.
I'm sorry to take this to me, but probably it's for the best.
I'm sorry, I've got to go now.
Okay.
Oh, you have to go now. Well, I hope I see you again.
Thanks a lot for coming.
Okay.
True.
So anyway,
nice to meet you,
yeah?
Darling.
Yes. See you later.
Bye.
What's the
nice voice of you?
I was a little
very nice. So, tell me about your home life. What's it like at home? I mean, your same tenants aren't all that.
Well, no. My mum and dad, they both work, so I don't live here. I've got six brothers, and they were always horrible to me. I mean, they used to beat me up and push me around, and they used to have to do all the washing, the cleaning, the cooking. And I used to have to run home from school so I could get everything done before my parents got home from work, before they were annoyed with me. Being the only girl, I'd be one of my parents' favourites, but in my family it just never worked that way.
Well, I'll let you stay here, you know, as long as you're going to go out and get a job and until you settle down together and everything, but you're going to have to make an effort to pull your way.
Thank you. Well, she can stay. I said she can stay.
But what about your husband?
What about him?
Will
we
do two things about
it? Well, we'll talk about it. You can stay
there. I got in me liquor, don't talk
look
to me.
Look at the state of him.
I got in me liquor, don't talk to me.
Hi, love. Where is it? You're going as soon as I come?
I'm going up to the
city. You're fighting for me, huh?
No.
There's no need to be scared of me, either. Hey.
State of you. Where have you been?
Hello, darling. How are you? All right?
Where have you been?
I've been out and had a couple of drinks.
You don't need any more drink now.
Listen, darling, I need...
Look, I want to talk to you, Joseph.
Let's talk then, darling. Let's talk. No, what do you want to talk about?
Where have you been?
I went to the pub. I had a few cans, you know, and visited a friend straight from work.
Why can't you come home?
Nah, I just don't feel like it really, you know?
We've got things to sort out here and you're out drinking.
I know we've got things to sort out here, man, but when I'm at home, I don't feel too relaxed, really. I feel as though I'm half a man, but if I'm out in the pub having a drink, I can swing back and put up my foot and feel like a real man in the pub, you know, because nobody really don't know the inside story of the place, you know what I mean? They only can get what's happening there, you know? They can see me there having a beer and smoking a cigar, maybe.
Like that makes you feel really
that
good.
Makes me feel nice, yeah. But indoors, sitting down with you, we argue all the time. You can't have that all the
time. We argue because
darling.
You're never home and you're always drunk.
Nah, darling, I'm not always drunk. When I'm not home, as I say already, I'm a businessman. I do my business. I do my work business and I do my alcoholic business.
Yeah. I mean, why can't you? We never even have a chat. All the time we've been together, we've never had a serious talk. I'd like to talk to you now.
Of course we haven't. Well, then let's talk now then. What do you want to talk about? You want to talk about that no good boy again? That good for nothing boy of yours again?
It's not good for nothing. You just don't understand him. That's all it is.
What is there to understand about that boy? Yeah?
There's a lot.
Like what?
Him? His way of life?
All I can see is him. I can't see nothing else. Really. There's nothing more besides that.
Because you've never bothered to look at him. You've never bothered to try to understand your own side.
Alright, girl, don't talk to me about that now.
I
want to talk about something.
I don't need to have any drink. I want to talk to you.
I think you should have a drink. You're worried too much.
I don't need any drink.
You need a drink.
You need drink because you can't back yourself up.
No, I can back myself up, especially if I...
You've had enough drink, Joseph.
Oh, right, darling. You see, the girl don't fear me as well. What's the matter?
There's a lot wrong.
Like what? The same problem with him again?
You.
Why don't you do like me and join my club? Instead of drinking tea, drink tea. Tell him, you know, have a brew, strong lager or something like that, a couple of whiskeys, and forget all your problems, love. Drown your problems, you know. Just float away in some nice drink. Well, you want to...
Are you prepared to listen to me?
Well, yes, well, of course I'm listening. Come on then, tell me, talk to me then. What are you saying now?
Anyway,
what's the problem?
Zainab, I told her that she could stay.
You did what?
I told her she could stay.
No, we're going to be bad friends. Talk now, let's drink. We're going to be bad friends. I said from the first beginning, I don't want that girl staying in here. She's a nice enough girl, all right, but when she gets in here, she'll be too comfortable, you know, she wouldn't want to leave.
But she has to stay here.
She's going to go out and try and get a job, right? Is she going to try to get a job?
Yes, she can do things. She can type and that.
Can she type?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she'll stay here until they get money and they can get their own
flat. And you come to that conclusion on your own. You never even consulted me to say
that. I don't have to consult you.
Of course you've got to consult.
Why?
What are you talking about?
Why?
I am in this place.
The man in this place, you know you've gone. When Sylverius was a baby, you've gone away from him for 5 whole years. I've had to try on my own.
Those were hard times then. I really wasn't too keen into this husband business then, you know what I mean? But
well, that was too bad. And this place is mine now.
No, you're getting it wrong. Look. This place is ours.
It is not ours, it is mine.
This place is ours.
Why is it ours?
Because I have paid bills. The place is in our name. We've got a mortgage saying Mr. and Mrs. Joseph.
It has Mrs. Joseph.
It has Mr. and Mrs. Joseph.
And besides, I've never seen your money anyway. Bad drink.
Maybe you don't realize that I bring in a pay packet as well. I bring in something. I leave it under the mantelpiece there.
Leave the empty envelope under the mantelpiece.
Yeah, but if I leave it for a couple of hours and you don't take it up, I feel like you don't want it, you know, and I go and take it up again. So
then
you can't see.
When you get paid, where do you go?
Well,
you go out drinking. And that's your life. Nothing else?
Nah, I have a game of pool sometimes. You know, I put on a bet on the dog sometimes.
Put a bet on the dog to play pool. Come on, what else?
Well, don't ask me where I go, lady. How can you be asking me questions like that?
I'm asking because I want to know, that's why.
You want to know where I go, but when?
I don't see what you got to come back into my house after you've gone for ages anyway.
Listen, love, this is our house that we've been and
it's
I've been
not
saying.
Ours, I've told you once already.
Hmm? Listen, woman, I am the man of this place, right?
Why are you
and
the man
you
of
get
this place?
That straight, right? Huh?
You've never cared
because,
about me.
Because
you've never
I am the man
me.
Of this place, right?
You're not a man for this place anyway.
Every time. Coming in, you always argue.
Listen, boy, we are not
always
arguing, right?
Argue.
We are here discussing your future.
This is not discussion.
Huh?
We are from outside.
Yes, but we are discussing in a loud tone, you know?
We're not
loud tone, exactly. You argue, that's what you do, argue. You never hear when you come here, you argue.
No, we're talking.
When you come back, you don't do what you want to do after you've been away for so long.
He can't
right.
even talk, he can't talk.
All
anyway.
Right, Sylverius, we are talking
Maybe,
about your future.
Right, about my past, right? Let me one time actually sat down with him to talk to him like father and son.
Nah, I don't believe in that.
Exactly. You have to. You have
that,
to.
That
talk
is what
to
is needed.
Listen,
that is
what
why
is
we
important
are where
though
we are
is the present. What are you going to do with a job?
Well, what's there to do? Look for a start, and if I can't find nothing, I have to wait with patience till I get something.
I tell you what I'm going to do. I would allow you to stay in this house, right? You can stay in this house, providing you find yourself a job.
Providing right. I find a job.
Yes.
So if I don't find a job tomorrow, I'll be staying there.
No, you'll have to find somewhere else to go. You've got to go and do something else. Right? I tell you, only you can stay in this place.
What
right?
about Zainab?
So if I can't, then I'm going to read it.
Zainab can stay here.
I said Zainab can't stay here.
I said that she can.
All right? That is the issue.
She
and
has
you
got my permission and she's staying here.
Listen, there's no more argument about that. I say she can't and you say she can.
I said
but
she
we'll
can stay
see
here.
Who, she's, who can stay. Right? If I can't have my way in this house, nobody will live in this house. Right?
Are you forgetting one thing though?
I'm not forgetting the thing. If I can't have my way in this house, I'll
I've
burn
had
the
enough
place
of
over.
You. I'm gonna make some tea.
Yes, you go. You have good happy riddance.
I can't chat to you.
No,
you
I don't want. I don't want to chat to you.
You don't
make
sense
you know?
To me. You don't.
Nah. Wonder if it's time for opening time yet. Club soon open. Hello, darling. Sit down, let me have my seat here. How's things?
Not too bad, thank you.
Yeah, it's nice to see that you're recovering all right and everything is all right with you.
Yeah, I've got somewhere to stay as well.
Have you? Oh, yes, where are you staying?
Thank you.
Oh, did she tell you can stay then?
Yeah.
Oh, that is nice. I really always wanted you to stay, but I really, you know, it wasn't my fault that you that things got that bad. It was her, really. She never wanted you to stay, but she, you know.
And I thought you were still such a nice family. You are, anyway.
Yeah, we are a nice family. I'm glad to hear that, really. Yes,
and you're nice and wonderful as well.
Yes, are you, yes, guy.
Yeah.
Yes, that's my boy. That's my boy there. I tell you that. You know, that's my boy. He's not too bad, you know. Yes, you can stay anytime you as for as long
my
as...
My God, you hypocrite sod!
What are you talking about now?
Did I tell you you could stay now?
Listen, I did tell you
could... talking.
Listen, I won't have no more of this, right? I can't take this note any longer.
Then go!
I'm going, right? I'm going. You ladies sit down and have your chat, right?
How dare you put ahead with all this lies?
Bye-bye then.
How do you mean he was lying?
He was saying that you could not stay and he wouldn't have you here. He didn't even want his own son here.
He told me that you didn't want me here.
Oh, for God's sake, that's a drink talking.
What's the matter with you? You look like you just woke up.
I've got a lot of problems today.
What's
just home, really. Not Joseph's like, he's always drunk and less there.
Not buying it or anything, though.
Well, a bit, yeah. Plus, Sylverius has got his girl pregnant. And he's got chucked out to lose the baby, isn't it? And I said they can stay.
Mm.
And we've had a lot of problems about them staying. Joseph's been finally selling the cards back.
Why?
Why? Because he doesn't want the girl there.
So what about... Well, how can he not want the girl there and it's Sylverius' woman?
Well, that's why he's out of there. Something. He's fed up now anyway.
So what are you going to do?
I really don't know.
Well, you can't live your life the way you're living it now. I'm telling you now. You can't. You're just depressing yourself, no one else.
I know what you're saying, but it's not that easy, really.
Sharon, it is that easy. Whose name is the Ayrton in any case?
It's in mine.
And once he's gone, or once you find to live your life as you please, right, you won't have to keep turning to him wherever you want to go out. You just get up and say, right, I'm ready to go out and go. That's what I'm doing now, and I feel a lot better for it.
I know, but we're all different.
But it's no but, Sharon. I can see you unhappy when you come into work. You're just like a zombie, you're just walking about in a daze. That's how I was. But you'll snap out of it. Once one of them's out of your life, once he's out of your life, you'll start living again. You will. It may sound hard, but it can be done.
What about seeing my sister the other day? I was talking to her. She said the same thing.
I mean, if you get two people saying it, who's wrong? You or us?
Probably me, but... I guess time will tell anyway.
The only thing you can do is try. If you want to be able to get that sound from you, can do.
I mean, I can't even talk to him. I've tried speaking to him. I mean, all throughout our marriage, we've never really sat down and had a serious talk together.
He's always been being married.
Bloody drunk and that.
If you can't talk to him, if you can't talk to him if you're married, well, what are you doing?
Thinking about Sylverius, really.
You've got to think about yourself sometimes. Sylverius can look after himself, can't he?
Yeah, I know, but he ain't got a job or nothing.
Yeah, that's not your fault.
You ain't really got a father, if you ask me.
That's not your fault. You've tried. You've got to make your mind up. And quick.
Yeah. Better go lunch now, I think.
Hmm.
Anyway. I'll see you later.
Yeah. Right?
All right. Play right from freedom backyard, or let you have the bank. African children, I live in situation. African children, I wonder if they know where you're coming from. African children, what we live in a concrete situation. African children.
Listen, boy, you're sitting in my chair, you've got your... Well, take your feet off me table. Music. What's the matter with you? Didn't you want to... Well, I said take your foot off
right,
the table.
Well, cool now.
Huh?
Easy now.
Get off me chair as well. Come on, get up. Come on, sit with your woman. Huh? So what have you all been up to all day?
What do you want to know for? You're interested in finding out what we've been doing all day.
I want to know if you all have been out looking for a job or something like that, you know?
I think that's stupid or something like that. You think it's that easy looking for a job to get?
Yes,
like that?
Do something constructive better than sit down in the place and...
Well, talking
about
our life. Something
on,
constructive.
This music on, besides this damn music on, so hard. Huh?
I was looking at the paper for a job.
Yeah?
Talking to you or no sense anyway.
I don't want to talk to you, boy. You're dead lost. I've given up on you.
So you think she's talking to you right?
I think at least she should have a bit more sense than you.
Talking to you means nothing.
Let me have a beer. Let me get myself... And you're drinking the beer as well?
Well, first thing I drink, right?
Now, boy, stand up, man. Get up and talk to you as a man now. Come on.
You don't talk. You don't talk. You're going to talk at last.
Sitting down in my best chair. Foot on the table. Drinking my last beer.
I've had enough.
Don't worry, we're good.
What happened? What's all this mess?
I think I've done it this time, love.
Done what?
I finally got rid of them this time.
You did what?
Yes, I think they're going. They're gone, I think. What do you think he is in this place? What do you think they are?
You got rid of them. You made them bloody go. Why is it always me? Everything I've ever done for this bloody ass has gone to pieces. All my friends have got decent husbands. I've got nothing. Do you think I really bloody deserve that? I come every day from work, right? And I do all the work. You've done nothing. You've done nothing for this bloody place.
We're here alone.
I've had enough of you. Don't tell me. Don't give me that baby talk. I've had enough of you.
Listen.
I don't want to listen to what you've got to say. Don't me. It's too late. And furthermore, you're going to hear from me soon.
I don't know. The end? Is this really the end? Am I going to be in this place all on my own and nobody to talk to? Nobody to discuss family life with? The boy was an alright boy, but... What have I done? What is the matter? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Where am I going to go from there? Place. What's the use of having a place and not a family? Having a house? No one in the place? I can't stand it. I really can't. What am I going to do about this?
No.